The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1941, Filter, then Paste Links. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and here's a real problem that I encountered yesterday during training. This was Jody from Ohio. Gets this big spreadsheet from corporate, much larger than this, with years and years worth of data going across. And you see for each project, there's all of these different types down the left-hand side. This data changes frequently, and Jody needs to create a chart showing all of the man hours from here. And so right now, Jody is kind of having to go through and select the first data and then hold down the Control key and select the next data. But you can imagine, as you're doing 48 of these, you know, somewhere along the line you accidentally misclick and then you have to start all over again. So instantly, the first thing I thought of is, hey, you know, this would be a great little macro that I could knock out here during the training, and that would copy just the man hours to the other sheet. And then you could change this macro, you know, to get the budget or the actuals and quickly make copies of the data. But then, you know, I heard Jody say that the data is frequently changing. You know, they'll make some changes and, hey, go update those charts right away. And I realized that just doing a static copy from the macro might not be the best way to go. I briefly thought about, let's select the whole thing, Control F, look for man hours, find all, and then in the find all press Control A, which selects all of those man hours, hoping that then somehow I could either shift spacebar or Control Shift right arrow. But unfortunately, all of those only work from the active cell. They don't take all of these items and select them. Again, shift spacebar selects the entire row, but only from the active cell, not from the selection. Then I said, all right, well, there's little chance that this is going to work, but what the heck, let me try it. Let's turn on the filter. And by the way, Jody had already tried turning on the filter, which created a great chart for just man hours, but then she also had a created chart for budget and actuals, and as you know, every time that you change the filter, the chart was changing. But I said, you know, let's take this data from here. I'm going to do Control Shift down arrow, Control Shift right arrow, and Control C to copy, and then go back to our worksheet where we're going to build the chart, and just for the heck of it, see if home, paste links, if that would manage to create a data set pointing back into the original data set. And to my surprise, it worked perfectly. So there's the first project on C2, and then the next project on C14, and then the next project on C26. Then as this data back here, we can undo the filter. As this data back here changes, so I'll change that from 1336 to 20,000, just to make sure it's really large. You see that those changes will be reflected. All right, and then, I mean, it's an ugly looking chart, in my opinion, to have all of these man hours, but that's the chart that her, you know, the higher ups need. So we're not going to argue that point. But this is a great way to create a live data set that's pointing into that big data set, this ugly data set that came from corporate. You know, Jody has to live with this. She didn't create this. It's just what was forced upon her. Copy, filter, copy, and then paste links. Save the day. Well, hey, I want to thank Jody for that great question. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.